Welcome to Finn Nature's Ruff Heights. This is a film to show you where the heights are and how the shore is. At the moment, it's cold and a freezing wind. It's spring, really early spring, so don't panic. Spring will come, and in this region, it comes fast when it's time. So let's see how the heights and the roads are.
When you come to the Finn Nature's Ruff Heights, please notice that the road is normal field road. So when you rent a car, please rent a car which is suitable for this kind of roads. Depending on spring, it might be wet and muddy. If your car is not suitable for this kind of roads, please leave your car to the nearest asphalt road. Park it there and walk 1.5 kilometers to the parking place what we use with the cars. In the end of the road, there's our parking place. When you park, please notice that don't block the whole parking place. Our farmer might come and he needs to get here with his tractor, and there might be also other photographers at the heights. When there are several photographers, please remember that some of the photographers might stay overnight in the height and some of the clients might stay only evening session, and they might leave in the midnight. So you need to park your car so that everyone can leave from the parking place if needed. When you have parked your car, take your rubber boots, because quite often the shore is wet and muddy, so you need rubber boots when walking to the heights. Walk a little bit back and turn right. You can see we have small signs here which tells where our heights are. And you can see here in the edge of the field that we have signs to this direction. Turn right and walk a little bit and you can see new signs which leads you towards our heights. Follow the signs to the heights. It's about 200-300 meters walk from the car to heights. When you arrive to the heights, you can see the heights on your right side. Our office have told you the number of the height where you will stay when you come to the heights. Please mark that to yourself and make sure you go to the height what number you have got. If you have several sessions, you will use different heights or several different heights. And if you will stay overnight, then we have booked evening and morning session in the same height for you to make it possible to sleep during the night in the height. This is how the height looks from inside. I will show it more carefully later. First, when you come to the height, please remember to take your shoes off first. That is important, because if you come with these muddy shoes to inside the height will be really muddy and nobody can lay down there and photograph from the low angle. We have a box for the shoes inside the height. You can take this box, open it, put it outside and put your shoes in there to avoid the shoes get wet. It is also possible to put the shoes on the side this way, so if it's just a slight rain, the boots are not wet. When you come inside, you can see that they are higher and lower level for photography, so all the photographers can get two cameras. We have some beanbags in the heights, not for everyone, and then we have places for the camera heads. So please bring your own camera head, video head, gimbal, ball head. You can attach it to here. It's a sledge what you can slide to left and right, or you can tie it down from here. All the places have the similar sledge. Take the canvas from here and open the canvas and put your camera through from the canvas. Tie it up. When you have done your photo session, please put the canvases back in the same position like they are, because this avoids the water coming in. If it's really rainy, the water might come through the canvases inside the hide. We don't want the hides get wet. Also, if it's really windy and the canvases are not here, they might fluff in a hide if there's no one in one hide. So please check that they are firmly tightened, the canvases, when you leave from the hide. We have the net here. It is really, really important to leave the net down, especially in the evening when you have backlit. I've seen that some clients will lift the net like this. Obviously, you will see it's much nicer. You can see more easier outside, but the birds will see you also, and they don't like that. So, and that will affect to the photography. The birds will go further away. So please make sure the net is down. What else we have in a hide? We have two kind of chairs. We have smaller ones and the bigger ones. If you want to use chairs. We have also this tracking mattresses to make it easier to lay down. What else we have? We have toilet seat or bottle for the guys. Please remember to empty the toilets if you use those. So when you leave from the hides, please empty the toilets outside and wash them with the water outside. So in every hide, we have this kind of gel candles for heating. They're not strong heaters, so please bring enough clothes to the hides. Don't use as bright colors as I do. Use black, dark colors. When you have these bright colors, all the birds will see you and the movement from inside the hide, and that will chase the birds a little bit further away. So dark clothes are important in a hide, but take warm clothes so you are not freezing. We have these gel candles. You can open them with a screwdriver. You will put the screwdriver underneath the lid and open it like this. We have gel here. We have also matches. It's a good idea to bring your own, because we don't know if people have remembered to close the jar and keep the matches dry. If they are here openly, they will be wet and they're not working. So bring your own matches. Use match to light the candle like this. And here we have a heating. In the corner here, we have the black metal thing where you can see the black thing there, where you put the candle to burn. The metal thing brings a little bit more safety. Yes. We have the emergency number 112 on the door. Also, we have the address for the place. So if you really need a help, then use the 112 and the address on the door. Please be careful with the fire, because it's easy when you lay down and you are concentrating on photography to put something to the candle. So be careful with that. We don't want to burn the hides. We don't want to burn you. I hope this video helps you with your planning when you are coming or plan to come to our Ruff hides. If you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to contact our office info@finnature.fi.